Hi, everybody. Reese Davis with you, bringing you the EA Sports NCAA Football 14 pregame show presented by Nissan. Innovation that excites. Pac-12 expansion has only enhanced this conference's credibility on a national scale. New coaches bringing great new innovative ideas, particularly on offense, gives this league an opportunity for a showcase like we're about to enjoy. We've done all we can do here. Time to tee it up. Let's send it out to Brad and Kirk for the call. David and I will be with you at halftime.
Before we head down to the field for the coin toss, we'd like to remind you this game is brought to you by Coke Zero. Real Coke tastes, zero calories. Enjoy everything. Missouri is lined up to kick the ball off first, and we are ready to go. He sends this one deep. This one's going to be down in the end zone for a touchback. So let's see what the offense can do as they come out onto the field. He's still going. And he carries the ball for a nice gain. Second down, and they're going to need about 3 yards to pick up the first down. And he stopped behind the line.
The defense had that one called perfectly. That's a big play on that loss.
There.
I'll tell you what, the defense gambled a bit here and came with the blitz, and a quarterback showed tremendous poise by making a good read and delivered a nice ball to the open man.
From their own 38-yard line, first down. Just throws this one away. The 47. Nice pickup as they connect on the pass play.
Well, they look to be in sync right now. They're both reading the defense properly, and the result is a nice gain.
From the 47-yard line, it's first down. Throw, incomplete pass.
Larry. Hey, check mic 33.
Throws to the back quickly, off his hands, incomplete. Third down now, and they need to get it down to the 37. It fly. Gets it. He's in space. Touchdown, Aggies. He splits the uprights with the extra point. Reese Davis joins us in the studio with this update. Reese?
The Warhawks win it 23-20.
Thanks, Reese. 7-0 game here. Colts ready to kick. Young takes it from the 6. And down he goes at the 30. The quarterback brings his troops out of the field for the first drive of the game. Tackle at the 38-yard line. So the offense will move a little bit closer with that penalty. First down, 10 to go. Ball on the 47. Takes it up the middle for a nice run. 7 yards there on that bit of misdirection. The 26.
Really a nicely thrown ball and a good job by the receiver to run right under it.
It's first and 10. Ball on the 26.
Here we go.
He makes it to the 25-yard line. Around the 16-yard line. So it's third down, and they're just inches away from picking up the first down. The 10. What a play, and that is first and goal.
A pass like that is so hard to defend because the defender doesn't have a great play on the ball unless it's underthrown. It's all based on connection between the quarterback and his receiver.
Nice run up the middle. This is the 8th play of this drive.
Keep gaining negative yards, and you put yourself in a position of having to make bigger and bigger plays. Puts a lot of pressure on that quarterback.
The ball's on the 6-yard line, and we've got third and goal. And he's hit before he can go anywhere. Kicks up, and it sails through the uprights.
Even though they gave up a field goal here, that defense is feeling pretty good about themselves right now. It could have just as easily been a touchdown.
Missouri gets set to kick this one away. And he got all of this one. Great kick. And it goes into the end zone, down for a touchback. The offense will be hoping they can move the ball as well as they did on their last drive.
I think the defense right now is just sitting back on their heels. They're allowing the offense to kind of dictate things to them. And the one thing is that any defensive coordinator would tell you in the country, you have to be the one trying to dictate things to the offense. So change it up. Try something different. If it's not working, you can't continue to sit back on your heels.
It's second down, and they're about 2 yards away from the sticks. Utah State holds a 4-point lead. Shows his running ability. Inside the 30. To the 10. Touchdown, Utah State. converts the extra point. A quick two-play, 75-yard drive, and the result, 7 points.
You know, you always prepare your offense to think that we're going to have some success. These guys got to be coming over the sidelines after touchdown saying, man, I didn't expect it to be this easy.
So at the end of one quarter, Utah State leads 14-3. The kicker looks like he's ready to kick this one off. He's to the 20. Across the 30. He wasn't breaking that tackle. What a hit. Welcome back here. We resume action now here in the second quarter. You think about the challenges these two teams are facing. On one side, you've got to find a way to keep building on your lead. And on the other side, you've got to find a way to get back in it. He's taken down at the 44.
Concentration lapse right there. The coaches will be giving them an earful for it, too.
First and 10. Ball on the 41-yard line. And they get nice yardage on that run. Makes it out to about the 26. First down, 10 yards to go. Ball on the 26-yard line. He makes it out maybe to the 26-yard line. The quarterback decided to pitch it on the option, but the back had nowhere to go.
Just a perfect defensive scheme for stopping that. They got to the option before it got to them.
It quickly, and he's got it, and he's taken down around the 5-yard line. That one goes for good yardage and a first down.
Yeah, that's just a nice gain on second down.
First and goal, and they need a touchdown here to get back in this game. Touchdown, Tigers! And he tacks on the extra point. So a 5-play, 57-yard drive, and they get it in for 7.
And Brad, right now the offensive line just winning the battle in the trenches, opening up some big running lanes.
It looks like they're ready for the kickoff. He kicks it off, and he got all of that one. He's to the 20. Taken down by the kicker. With one quarter down, I really haven't seen too much separation between these two squads. Might be neck and neck the whole way. Utah State is up 4. He makes the catch and has a first down. From their own 48-yard line, first down. Pulls it in, and he's in the open field. And they make the stop at the 40-yard line. He's tackled around the 38-yard line. from the 38-yard line. Second down. And he hits him hard at the 30-yard line. At the 20. Brought down at the 18-yard line. First and 10. Ball on the 18-yard line. Here's an opening. Nice play to set up first and goal. They go with the option and pick up the first down.
Yeah, and that was a situation where the quarterback knew he could pick up the first down if he kept it himself. That's a good decision.
Utah State is up by 4. And they got to him before he could get back to the line.
You know, it looked to me like he should have made the pitch, but he kept it instead and wound up going backwards.
From the 10-yard line, second down. Bring him down at about the 13. A loss on that one as he couldn't get past those big linemen.
You got that right. They sacrificed their bodies in there and stuffed him.
And this is the 9th play of the current drive. He fires right side.
You like a team that's ready to defend the pass. It takes some preparation to get in the way of a pass like that.
They'll line up for the field goal, and this is nothing more than a chip shot. It's up, and it's good.
And you got to think they're pretty happy with holding them to a field goal right there.
Colts has the ball all teed up, and he's ready to kick this one off. He'll return it from the 4-yard line. They'll bring him down at the 36-yard line. Momentum swings have been fairly even, and with so little separation, this game can be drastically changed on just one or two plays. Run there.
Excellent job by the defense to bring him down inbounds and keep that clock moving.
They're about 4 yards away here on second down.
Here we go.
Tackle made right around the 48-yard line. Slings it, and he's tackled at about the 37-yard line.
You've got to play with that kind of purpose to move the ball against this defense.
From the 37-yard line, first down. Makes the catch, and he's got nowhere to go. Picked off.
Almost a big play. He patrols the deep part of the field like a center fielder, though he didn't make the catch like one.
Third down, and they need to get it to the 27.
Here we go.
Grabs it and hammered right there. Thank you. He gets it up, and it's good. Great first half of action, and we're hoping for more of the same. So the Aggies lead it by four.
Hi, everybody. Glad to have you with us on the EA Sports NCAA Football 14 Halftime Show presented by Nissan. Innovation that excites. Davis, David Pollack here in the studio, as always, to lend a little perspective to what just went.
All right, Reese and David, thanks, guys. Second half action just about ready to start here. He's to the 20. He makes it to the 28-yard line. Kirk, you and I like seeing points. We're seeing points in this third quarter. This has been fun.
And I think it's going to continue, Brad. I think the adjustments that were made at halftime have allowed these quarterbacks to go out and really be able to take command of how they want to attack each defense. It's going to come down to that final drive.
There's still plenty of time to keep running their offense as usual here. I don't think they need to feel any anxiety about trailing. He's to the 40. Gains his way to the 43-yard line. We've got a first and 10. Ball on their own 43. Complete, he's hit right away. Up the middle for a nice game. First down, 10 to go. Ball on the 45-yard line. And he tackles him hard at the 32. From the 31-yard line, it's second down. He goes out of bounds at the 29. Intercepted there.
Hey, that's a heads-up play there by the defender. Get those hands up and something good may just happen.
They'll call on the field goal unit here for this long field goal attempts. Flags are all over the place and they'll blow it dead.
Just a mental lapse, but it's going to cost them 5 yards.
It has the distance, and he nails the long field goal.
You know, I was wondering if he's going to get a chance to kick one of those. We saw him warming up from 60 yards before the game.
17-16, Utah State. Missouri is lining up to kick this one off. He sends this one deep. This one's going to be down in the end zone for a touchback. They're ready to begin another drive. They'll line up with five wide receivers. Going to go across the middle, caught. And down he goes, around the 34-yard line. Short yardage situation here. Second down and one.
Hey, watch the ball. Watch the ball.
Utah State up a point. Gets to around the 42. Guns it right side. Makes the grab and he's knocked out of bounds. Big play right there. Now it's first and 10 after the big pass play. He makes it out to about the 24-yard line. Completes it, but he can't shake the defense. And they're going to need about 3 yards to pick up the first down. Another run. There's a very impressive open field tackle. Kicks away. And it sails through the uprights. Looks like they're ready for the kick. He'll return it from the 3. Tackle at the 26. This deficit can be easily overcome, sure. But they have to be thinking if they don't get something going on this series, the burden is going to be felt by their defense. Caught, open field. Down the sideline. To the 20, the 10. And he's all the way in for the touchdown. So the kicker will line up here and try to give his team a 3-point lead with this extra point. He makes the PAT. They line up to kick this one away. He just drills this one. And it goes into the end zone, down for a touchback. Utah State's a team on a mission right now, it appears. They have put up 20 points in a row. There's still plenty of time to keep running their offense as usual here. I don't think they need to feel any anxiety about trailing. And he just gets rid of it. From their own 25-yard line. Second down.
Watch two.
Quick pass. And he's taken down around the 26-yard line. Quick release. Tight end. Incomplete. He makes it out to maybe the 46-yard line. Missouri's the higher-ranked team, and it's showing up right now.
I think it just took them a half to kind of get things going. They were a little sloppy early in this game. They've settled down now, and this is the team we expected to see.
This offense threw the ball extremely well on their last drive, and they ended up with a touchdown.
As long as this quarterback has time to throw, then you can guarantee that he'll find the open man.
And he is drilled at the 45. Second down and 11. Ball on the 45. Missouri holds a field goal lead. Caught, and he's hit immediately. That's three down and one to go. The Tigers with a three-point lead. All right, we're just about set to start action here again in the fourth quarter. Wow, a big stop there early in the fourth quarter. And the way this game has been played and how tight it's been, every defensive stop will be huge. Big kick here to try to pin the offense deep in their own territory. And this one is a beauty. This punt bounces into the end zone, and this will be a touchback. You know this is a real crucial time in the game. It could still go either way. And he throws it away.
You know, when you feel pressure like that, the worst thing you want to do is just to throw the ball into coverage. He got away with one right there. He's very fortunate. Next time, he should just throw it away out of bounds.
Second down, 10 to go. Ball on the 20-yard line. Scrambling around. He's out to the 30, and he hits him hard at the 32-yard line. The stop at the 30.
By the time the running back here got the football, he's looking up and he's got a couple defensive linemen closing in on him because they were able to slip off of their blocks. Really, there's nothing he could do at all there. That was more of a miscommunication and just getting overmatched up front by the offensive line.
Second down and 12. Ball on the 30.
Here we go.
He's got it with room to run. He's pushed out of bounds around the 41-yard line. He's tackled at the 49. First down, 10 yards to go. Ball on their own 49.
Here we go. Flag 85. Flag 85.
He scrambled. He gets sacked on the play.
I think that one's on the offensive line. They've got to do a better job of holding their blocks, or else this quarterback's going to be pulling turf out of his face mask all game.
So that sack sets them back a little bit now. They're looking at second and 13. Less than 3 minutes in the game. Pulls down the catch, and he's got room here. They'll bring him down at the 46-yard line. This is the eighth play of this drive. Go to the ground and he stops short. Oh. He'll try to knock this punt down inside the 20.
Able to deaden that kick perfectly, and he gives them a long field to work with.
This is a pretty crucial series right here. With things being so tight, your best players have to step it up on both sides of the ball. He's taken down right around the 18-yard line. A yard, maybe two on the carry. So the Aggies will use their first time out of the half. It's second and eight. Ball on the 18. Takes it up the middle for a nice run. Utah State will take a timeout. That's their second of the half. And he's tackled after positive yardage. The defense might have just run out of chances with that first down right there.
This offensive line definitely left it all on the field today.
From their own 28-yard line. First down. Tackle made at the 36-yard line. A gain of 8 on the carry. We have less than a minute to go. Nice run up the middle. It's first and 10. Ball on the 41. And this should be a kneel down as they just try to kill the clock. Favorite play in football of your quarterback. Take a knee. So this one goes final. A hard-fought, close game. 23-20, Missouri. So that wraps things up for us. For EA Sports and Kirk Herbstreit, I'm Brad Nessler saying thanks, and we'll see you next time.